Fox 4, Kansas City's 24-hour news channel.
This is a Fox Sports presentation. So, you had your stuffing of turkey, and now you're starving for some pigskin. Well, let's get going with some crucial Week 14 clashes right here on the one and only NFL on Fox. Out west, the Niners are riding high. And a win today could give them a postseason bye.
Work on three. One, two, three. One.
But winning at KC is never easy.
This is our house.
Especially since the Chiefs got their own playoff war.
We are the Kansas City Chiefs.
The Rams slammed to the Capitol to skirmish with the Skins.
In politics, last week's debacle in D.C. has sparked a new lobby group.
Yeah, it's called the Band of Boneheads Movement. Lately, Coach Dick has been clashing with his conscience.
I'm probably the wrong guy for this job, I'll say that.
I will be here. I intend to be here.
Should I stay or should I go? Today, his Saints hit Carolina as the Panthers try to roar back into the wild card chase.
Now we got to seize the opportunity.
This one promises to be an air show as the Flinging Falcons face the Slinging Seahawks. Chris's club has got their bark back. Well, in Seattle, old man Warren is still beating up on Father Time. The Bucks versus Giants in a game that has meaning?
That's right.
Hey, Tampa's solid on the ground, but look out. Big Blue's D can whack you with their record crew. Now, live from the Fox Television Center in Hollywood, four guys who've had plenty of dessert, but who are still sweet to each other. It's the one and only Fox NFL Sunday.
Well, with just 4 weeks remaining in the holiday season, the NFL remains crowded with teams shopping for a playoff berth. Today on Fox, the NFL's one sure thing. The San Francisco 49ers face their most difficult test, the Chiefs in Kansas City. Later on, this season's two biggest surprises, the Buccaneers and the Giants, square off at the Meadowlands. And hello again, everyone. I'm James Brown with my hand movement that they're mimicking as I welcome you to Fox NFL Sunday. Joining me, as we welcome your Ronnie, Howie, and Terry. You know, you guys are all so big with everything going. Howie with the movies, you raising millions for charity.
Charity.
Horses with world championship titles. What about Ronnie?
Ronnie's on the fire.
Frosted Wheaties.
Honey toasted.
All right, folks, when you get to Thanksgiving weekend, it's time to focus in on the playoff picture, and there's a lot at stake today. First off, San Francisco can clinch a first-round bye with a win against Kansas City. Now, speaking of the Chiefs, they can clinch a playoff spot with the win over the Niners, as well as losses by New England and Miami. And a Denver win against San Diego tonight puts the Broncos in the playoffs. But with 16 out of 30 teams within 3 games of each other, the playoff picture is far from complete. Now let's turn to the respective conferences. In the AFC division races, the Jets lead the East. Pittsburgh has the tiebreaker. Pittsburgh has a tiebreaker over Jacksonville. And of course, Denver leads the West. So that means Kansas City is at the top of the wild card race. Jacksonville has the next spot. Miami and New England, who are tied for the final spot, play each other the final week of the season in Miami. And Tennessee's Thanksgiving Day win over Dallas keeps the Oilers very much in the AFC wildcard race. Now, in the NFC, the surprising Giants atop the NFC East. Green Bay leads the Central, but travels to Minnesota Monday night, and you know how much difficulty they've had there. They've not won there under head coach Mike Holmgren. And as you know, San Francisco has won the West. All right, the wild card race shapes up this way. Minnesota and Tampa Bay are in the driver's seat, but both are very much alive in the Central race. After that, Washington would get the third spot, but Detroit, which has won 3 straight, is just one half game back, with Carolina, Philadelphia, and even Dallas all still with the shot. Well, with all that happening, you're probably not going anywhere for a while, so let's get to our Snickers Fox Watch. As you saw, San Francisco is looking to clinch a first round bye today, while a Chiefs win with some help could put them in the playoffs. Pat Summerall and John Madden are at Arrowhead Stadium, and good afternoon, gentlemen.
Good afternoon, JB. It's 43 degrees, overcast, right now some light rain, but that's supposed to be over by the time the game starts, so that shouldn't be a factor. Injuries, well, the 49ers will welcome back Tim McDonald, who's missed a couple of games with a bad foot. For the Kansas City Chiefs, Kimball Anders, their fullback, is out with an injured ankle. And a lot of people have been asking about Jerry Rice, the great Jerry Rice. And if yesterday at practice was any indication, he'll match his target date of December the 15th. That's when he says he'll be back. This is just a few moments ago before the game here at Arrowhead. So he looks pretty good, and indeed it looks like he might make it. Now, as far as this game today, it's one of those games, we think at least, that'll be won in the trenches.
Yeah, and I love that kind of football because it usually is one in the trenches where, you know, which line is going to dominate the other line. And when you look at this matchup here today, we have two good lines generally, but specifically inside we have a great matchup because the strength of the Kansas City offensive line is their three inside guys. Wilt Shields, their right guard, Tim Grunhard, their center, Dave Zott. This is the strength of their offensive line. Now, if you look at the 49ers, the strength of their defense are these two defensive tackles, Bryant Young, Dana Stubblefield. So what we have here is, you know, these three guys against these two guys in the middle, and who wins that battle is going to go a long ways in who wins the game today.
That is a battle we'll be watching. Now let's send you to Washington and Paul Kennedy.
Thanks so much, Pat. As the Rams arrive in Washington for the first time in 10 years, as you can see, there is rain in the forecast. Redskins fans concerned that their team might hit the wall as they did a year ago when they faded in the second half of the season. It was at this spot last Sunday night that Gus Frerotte literally hit the wall. The Redskin quarterback attempting the first ever Jack Kent Cook Stadium leap came up a bit short. Jammed his neck. He is healthy. Will start for the Skins today. The more conventional ramming speed will come out of fullback Larry Bowie, who is healthy again after ankle problems, and Terry Allen. St. Louis has dropped eight in a row. It's the Redskins and the Rams as we go on to Charlotte. Here's Tom Brenneman.
Paul, thank you. The Saints and the Panthers today in Charlotte, and another quarterback for Mike Ditka. In fact, the Saints have served up more quarterbacks already this season than a bartender does hurricanes at Pat O'Brien. Take a look at this. It started with Heath Shuler, went on to Danny Werfel, Doug Nussmeier, and now Billy Joe Hobert, the starter today, trying to cut down on turnovers, which have killed the Saints all year. And JB, by comparison, the Saints have used more quarterbacks this season than there have been head basketball coaches at the University of North Carolina in the last 54 years.
And we know there haven't been many of those, only the second change. All right, folks, for those of you not getting an early game, you'll see either the NFC East leading Giants hosting the Buccaneers or Atlanta at Seattle as we come back inside to the Fox Television Center. Howie, so much has been talked about the Washington Redskins, a lot of young offensive talent, still needing some maturity, maybe some veteran leadership needed here and there. But are the Redskins ready for primetime postseason play?
Well, they haven't shown that as of yet, JB. You know, they need to develop a consistent running game to take the pressure off the quarterback. It seems like it's an old story in the NFL. Everyone seems to need to run the football to protect their quarterback, and today's no different. They expect them to run at Kevin Carter. Bowie being back at fullback is a big key. The Redskins need a dominant defensive lineman. They do not have one. You have to have one. You look at San Francisco, they've got four. They've got four guys that get after the quarterback. Over 250 sacks on the defensive end position for the San Francisco 49ers. They don't have anybody. They rely solely on those cornerbacks and the safety rolling up. St. Louis team is a disappointment. Unlike the New Orleans team that Mike Ditka inherited, this team has some talent. They have not realized that talent.
Yeah, but you got to look at Bud Carson, the defensive coordinator. He will make some problems for Gus Frerotte at the quarterback spot. I know for a fact that he's going to do a lot of blitzing. He's going to come after Gus Frerotte and make him make good decisions with the football. On the other hand, Gus Frerotte on third down, they have to get the ball to Jamie Asher. Now that Leslie Shepard's out of the game, Terry, it's very difficult for this football team to move the ball.
Well, after the Beavis and Butthead act that we saw the other night, Washington could, well, you can always go back, listen, and look at one game a year and say, this cost us a playoff. You can almost always do that. You can't make bonehead mistakes like the quarterback made. Bud Carson will drive him crazy today. Henry Ellard to the post. You beat Bud Carson's defense by going deep.
Howie also made a point that Washington's defense doesn't really give them good field position very often either.
No.
All right, folks. Here's a look at what's happening around the NFL. Bobby Beathard is frustrated in San Diego. Last year, he forced out Bobby Ross, his head coach, and since appearing in Super Bowl 29, the Chargers are a sub-500 team. Now, the hottest NFL rumor last week was that Beathard was unhappy with his new coach, Kevin Gilbride, and was considering the general manager spot in Seattle. Now, when asked by Fox about the rumor, Beathard said, quote, "The way this season is going, who would want me? And if things keep up, I could be out of work and living next to Howie Long in Montana."
Did he give you one of them categorically denied type things?
Didn't say categorical, because you don't like that.
I can't spell it, but I like it.
All right, folks. And on Tuesday, Miami's Jimmy Johnson will meet with troubled running back Lawrence Phillips. Now, if Jimmy Johnson likes what he hears, Phillips could become a Dolphin immediately, signing for the league minimum, which in his case would be less than $10,000 per game. Well, we've just gotten things started going here. Here's a look at what else is on tap for today's show.
Today on the one and only Fox NFL Sunday.
Throughout his stormy NFL career, Andre Rison, I'm talking about Spider-Man, has had problems wherever he goes. Now, with a new nickname and team, Andre's back, weaving his way through defenses. Pam Oliver spins a tale or two with the Chiefs' superhero receiver. Pam. Hey, seeing a barber can be a little scary. Imagine how two guys named Tiki and Rondé feel. The Barber twins have been teammates their entire lives. Now they're on opposite sides for the first time. One question, who's mom gonna root for? So, pull up a chair and sit still. It's time to meet the Barbers. Then.
Next on Fox NFL Sunday.
You see them strutting their stuff every Sunday. But hey, these women have a lot more going on. When the cheering stops, there's another world to the sirens of the sidelines. Stay tuned as we expose the secret life of the NFL cheerleader. Coming up, coming at you.
On the Fox NFL Sunday.
There's the snap. Williams, wide open. Oh!
Come the team doctor.
This kid is tough as nails.
Real professional.
Are you hurt?
Yeah, I'm hurt. When people boo, it hurts my feelings.
Don't you think they have a right to boo?
No.
The ball hit you right in the numbers.
It didn't. I don't think the quarterback likes me.
Of course he likes you. The whole team likes you.
Why can't he feel my pain?
Post incompletion, stress disorder.
Not going anywhere for a while? Grab a Snickers.
Hey, turn that frown upside down. There you go.
Prove that Energizer lasts over 15% longer than Duracell in these camcorders. Here's Energizer management trainee Jeff Mackin.
My Jeff, and it's bye-bye, bunny.
Now,
ever sat in your boss's chair?
Yeah.
Okay. Which battery lasts over 15% longer in these camcorders?
Energizer.
Next time, pink.
Tuesday, join Kelsey Grammer, Roseanne, Tim Conway, Sybil Shepherd, Keenan Ivory Wayans, Candace Bergen, and more for the funniest and most touching comedy event of the year.
I've eaten so much rough edge that I'm beginning to pass wicker furniture.
The American Comedy Honors, Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Snickers. Not going anywhere for a while? Grab a Snickers. Hungry? Why wait? By Pizza Hut. Enjoy today's game with the Edge Pizza. New from Pizza Hut. 16 pieces of pure toppings. Have you been to the Edge? By Energizer. Long-lasting Energizer batteries keep going and going. And by Porsche, who wish to remind you there is no substitute.
Terry Bradshaw's favorite part of the show, the Porsche quarterback report.
Well, Neil O'Donnell, I didn't even know he was starting. Steve Young, that's good. Dilford George, what's he doing on there? Where's Favre? I'm going to go with Steve Young today.
Ah, you like Young of the 49ers,
bad
huh?
Bad boy. Okay, I can change it. I go with O'Donnell.
Back
I really could care less.
After this.
Reinhold Bertlev had a key role in the building of Porsche's 911 Carrera. Did he design the engine? The radical suspension? No. Instead, Reinhold and his co-workers have perhaps the best job in the world. They test drive every 9/11 on the Autobahn. If Reinhold likes your car, we're pretty sure you'll like your car.
Listen up. I have been to the edge and back, and I will tell you what I've learned.
What I have learned is you don't need outer crust.
Introducing the Edge Pizza from Pizza Hut, a new pizza with no outer crust, or the toppings go right to the edge.
Mushrooms right to the edge.
Pepperoni.
And sausages.
Right to the edge. I have been to the edge and back.
Joey.
16 pieces of pure pulchritudinous toppings. Have you been to the edge?
There's the snap. Williams, wide open. Oh, he blew it.
Here come the team doctors.
Are you hurt? Yeah, I'm hurt. The people boo. Hurts my feelings.
Gonna be a while? Grab a Snickers.
Posting compulsion stress disorder.
Love the hat.
Ugh, I need it.
My head's a disaster. Look at my dandruff.
You just need the right shampoo.
With regular shampoo, flakes can keep coming back, but Head & Shoulders helps stop flakes before they even start, so your hair looks great. Change dandruff problems into beautiful hair.
Will racial hatred destroy Hope Street?
I want you out.
I have a right to be here. The Bill of Rights says so.
The return of 413 Hope Street, Thursday at 9, 8 Central.
Get the world's fastest sport utility vehicle. Introducing the Grand Cherokee 5.9 Limited. Peterson's four-wheel and off-road magazine's 4x4 of the year.
Here's a rather simple math lesson. If you own or rent one of these and have one of these, you could save this. In fact, save up to 20% on your auto insurance with American Family. Just call an American Family agent. So let's review. One of these and one of these could save you up to 20% on your auto insurance. Told you it was simple. And all you have to remember are these three words.
American Family Insurance.
All your protection under one roof. An equal housing insurer.
This time of year, there's a sales event everywhere you turn. Watch out. Sometimes it's not what you think. Is this cold supposed to rub off? Why is getting the real thing such a big deal? Should be a non-event.
The real McCoy is easy to find at your GMC dealer. Now with GMAC financing as low as 2.9% APR or cash back up to $1,000 on select models. Getting the real truck you really want is easier than settling for less.
On mine, the hands move. Do you have one like that?
Get a great value and a great selection at your local GMC dealers.
You're watching Fox 4, Kansas City's 24-hour news channel.
As we welcome you back to Fox NFL Sunday, time now for our Fox Energizer playbook. And as you recall, last Sunday, Green Bay Packers quarterback Brett Favre effectively changed his cadence or the way he calls his signals to get the Dallas defense to jump off sides. Now, we've got the master magician here with a great set of pipes and a guy who loved to read whatever key he could find.
Can't you imagine me and Howie? Let me explain. The cadence is something that is my weapon. It's a weapon the quarterback of the offense uses. It's something that, first of all, you use to your effect in a crucial situation. Favre knew that Dallas got antsy on third and short. He used the long count, the change of the count, to get Dallas to jump offside. Voice inflection is the key, but first you have to establish a rhythm with your offense. You come up, you establish a snap count rhythm. Set, ready, hut, set, ready, hut, and you do that 15, 20 plays, and then you get in the huddle, and you tell them, it's on three, set, ready, hut, boom, here they come, hut, hut. So you establish it, it's to my benefit. Number two, I've got to have an offensive line that is patient. They can't be jumping off count, off sides, because we saw against Green Bay and the Vikings, they could not hold the count themselves.
What do you get when you get a guy jumping off the corner? You get a free play.
You get a, you get a free play.
Take it down the field.
Absolutely. Wow. Another thing is that you can use the count, the change of the count, to help a quarterback identify coverage. By changing the count, set, ready, hut.
Blitz.
Here he comes. I know right now if it's a pass, I can see from their tendencies what's
going to happen.
The other
thing is I would key zoom motion. If a wide receiver comes in motion in the backfield, starts chopping his feet right at the offensive tackle, it's on the next one. I'd key the quarterback. Quarterback come up on the line. Blue 42. As soon as his head would square up, I'd know it's on the next count. You go 1-3, 1-3, 1-3, 5, I'm gone. I had Kansas City go 7 on me 3-4 times.
What I'd thing? What were you in the locker room?
One thing a quarterback cannot do, he cannot do this. Set. You do that, it's against you, it's 5 yards.
They do it all day.
Give me a hut-hut as I'm doing this.
Set.
How about
hut-hut?
There are a number of other games this week that have an impact on a playoff scenario.
Hut-hut!
Check it out.
Four games to go and playoff thoughts fill the air. In the AFC East, the Jets are burning it up. Last week, Keyshawn turned a career best and now takes his act to Buffalo. But recently, the Bills' Big D has grounded the Jets. The Patriots are in hot pursuit and host the hapless Colts. Lately, when Drew's crew doesn't come through, the pass defense has picked up the slack. Miami's hopes are still alive, while Oakland's role is spoiler. Dan's been down the playoff road before, but when the fish come to Oaktown, the Raiders know the score. In the AFC Central, the Steelers and Jags are clawing at the top. This week, the bus rumbles into Arizona, and he doesn't intend to stop. Jacksonville hopes to pull away as Baltimore comes to town. The Jags look to keep their home streak alive, but in their last three against the Ravens, they barely survive. The Bengals travel to Philly to face the Eagles. Boomer's got these cats on a roll, but the Eagles and young gun Bobby aren't ruling out a wild card shot. In the AFC West, things are much closer than they seem. Denver travels to San Diego and with a win becomes a playoff team. On Monday, black and blue division rivals clash in a game that looms large in the NFC race. The Packers have the momentum after their Cowboys stampede, but the Vikes have the pack right where they want them and could tie for the lead.
Green Bay at Minnesota. Green Bay has not won at Minnesota since Mike Holmgren has been there in 92. That's 5 trips there. Any reason to think it'll be different come Monday night?
Yeah, I think that it will be, especially after last week beating Dallas. I think that Mike Holmgren right now has got the team playing and going in the right direction. But the key for this game is the seams. They're going to attack the seams. They're going to attack Orlando Thomas as well as Eugene Robinson, who I think is a decent safety. He's going to have some competition now that Mark Collins is signed by the Green Bay Packers.
You know what? You look at certain teams go to certain homes and just don't play well. I would travel with the Steelers down to Houston. I just stunk their joint up. It was just one house I didn't play well in. Green Bay just does not play well in Minnesota. One thing, Brad Johnson injured right ankle. He's fine, practiced all week. And Denny Green took his team outside for 3 days of practice to kind of revive their legs a bit. It's going to be hard. Faster team, Howie, on that turf is the Minnesota Vikings.
Yeah, Minnesota Vikings flat out feel that they are a better team on turf. They're built for turf. Green Bay's built for Lambeau Field. There's a story of two hats when we were up there before. Brett Favre got a lot of protection early on, tore that secondary part. He'll go after Fuller today. In the second half, Brad Johnson came out firing. Jake Reed has struggled a little bit versus smaller cornerbacks. They want him to get more physical, chuck those guys out of the way like Michael Irvin or Herman Moore. This game comes down to snap counts. Will the offensive line for the Green Bay Packers be able to handle that silent count versus that Minnesota front?
Terry, what does Denny Green have on Mike Holmgren? You know he's got something on him.
I don't know. Good point. I don't know. Well, that's good stuff. Mike Holmgren is only 8-23 on turf. How are you talking about Green Bay being built
something
for the outside? All right, folks, a lot more coming in today's show, including a look at a pair of twins who are facing each other for the very first time. Rooting for Tiki and Rondé Barber was simple when they played on the same team, but that's not the case anymore. And Andre Rison has had his share of ups and downs, but he's never doubted his ability to play the game.
I'm taking it as it comes. You know, I think the biggest thing that makes me happy is when I'm on my way to the game, I know I'm gonna get an opportunity to catch the ball.
Fortune 500 companies know that when it comes to renting a car, there's really only one place to go. National Car Rental. Because at most major airports in America, National gets you in your car and on the road fast. So what are you waiting for? Let's go. National Car Rental. It takes all three of these sanders to do everything the sandstorm does. It's three sanders for the price of one. The Sandstorm.
built by Black & Decker.
The Panasonic Razor. Shave wet or shave dry. Your choice. Your shave. Rinse clean. Work hard. Play hard. Shave your way. Panasonic.
I used to tell players, if you ever get a real hard hit, the best thing you can do to a guy is laugh at it.
Boom!
Smacks and you go. Most people want to cry, but you can't do that. The best reaction you can get is to laugh. That means you either you don't care or you like it. Either one of those are good for the hittee. That's my game. What's yours?
So, he really plays in them?
Yeah, Mark Brunell in the Nike Air Marauder.
Almost took him all the way last year.
A scrambler like him needs some real traction to make the plays he does.
Kerry Collins has the same shoes too, right?
You bet. He took him right past San Fran and through Cowboy Country.
Incoming.
Nobody gets you closer to the game than Foot Locker, where it all begins.
The X-Files presents a black and white horror tale.
Up there.
With a monster, a mad scientist, and an angry mob. Could it get any scarier than this?
Is it true Jerry Springer's coming to town?
An all-new X-Files, tonight at 9, 8 Central. So many mysteries, just one box.
Leading the league has become commonplace for the Niners, Steve Young. Once again, Young is the only quarterback with a passer rating above 100 and is on pace to lead the league for the sixth time. As we welcome you back to the Fox Television Center here in Studio 7. Well, today in Kansas City, the Chiefs host the 49ers. Now, San Francisco enters with an 11-game win streak and the NFL's best record, while a Chiefs win puts them a step closer to the playoffs. Winning is synonymous with these two teams. They currently have the NFL's most consecutive winning seasons. San Francisco at 15, Kansas City is second with 9. And the Chiefs' 9-3 record is surprising to most people, but what may be more surprising is the way wide receiver Andre Rison has quietly gone about his business. Pam Oliver joins us live from Kansas City. And Pam, Andre has had a very turbulent past, but do you think he's finally found a home?
Well, JB, he says he's found new life here in Kansas City. Now, few people would disagree that Andre Rison is one of the best receivers in the game. But historically, talent alone hasn't quite been enough to keep him in good standing the many places he's been. And we're talking 6 teams in 9 years.
I mean, everywhere I go, people say, here comes this... this thug, or this bad guy.
It's just me against the world.
And when I came to Kansas City, that was the biggest thing that I was concerned about, was how the players were going to react on the field, off the field. And they've been great. It's like I died and came back. And I think it's kind of puzzling people, because I'm here in Kansas City, I'm quiet, and I'm just doing my job.
And he's done everything necessary to win over even the hardest critics around this particular area, and there are some.
It's kind of hard to defeat, so you really have to stay tight within yourself. You can't trust anybody.
I told him, I said, we don't care about the past. The only thing we care about is what takes place from this day forward, if in fact you choose to be a Kansas City
Chief. I'm very thankful that the people of Kansas City, the staff here, gave him an opportunity to play, and I think he's done everything to show his appreciation.
I'm just having fun right now. I'm really calm. I'm really calm at this point in my career.
Rison may now have peace, but for the last 2 years, he's shown an uncanny ability to be shown the door. The common perception, he's trouble.
Jacksonville, it was like I was a rider, you know, on a Harley Davidson, just riding through life. And I just bumped into those people. But Cleveland, they did me wrong.
And Green Bay, a cost-cutting move left Rison out in the cold and feeling misled about his future with the defending Super Bowl champs.
It ended up being a lying situation, whereas they already knew. You know, my salary couldn't fit up under their salary cap, and I was going to be the third receiver, which I'm too good to be a third receiver. And that's what he felt, and I feel the same way, so.
Where's your Super Bowl ring?
I don't wear it.
Have you ever seen The Ring?
I've seen The Ring.
Where is it now?
I don't know, probably in a river somewhere.
Dad, actually, Andre, I'm for real. Your Super Bowl ring is.
Damn, I do not know.
Really?
I would tell the nation I don't know where my Super Bowl ring is at.
Rising's play as a Chief is reminiscent of the early days. His stats the first 6 years of his 9-year career make his the second best start by a receiver in history. Rising's hoping his final years in football are in a Chief's uniform.
I've been told, you know, by some respected people in this organization that I will retire as Spider-Man, yes.
Spider-Man. That's right. The player formerly known as Bad Moon Rising prefers Spider-Man.
This new identity is just something I came up with in the offseason. I just like the way he moves and his body movements, and he's quiet and he gets the job done.
And that, in a nutshell, will describe how Andre Rison is going about his business here in Kansas City. He hasn't given anybody anything to talk about except perhaps his play on the field, and he's playing some of his best football in years. To further demonstrate his commitment to making things work here, he's even purchased a home, anticipating staying for a while. And JB, if there's more you want to know about Andre Rison's career or football travails, he'll have a new rap CD coming out next summer with a book to follow, and I know you will be first in line.
No doubt about it. But Pam, before I let you go, Marcus Allen still a very fine running back? I just wanted to get a little reaction. That's all.
JB.
All right. Pam, thank you very much. All right. Let's talk a little bit about this game. TB, collect your composure. Teams fighting for a home field advantage historically have not done very well. My question is not having to go to Green Bay sufficient inspiration for San Francisco to play well today against Kansas City?
I want to play well right now for the remaining part of the season. I want to establish home field advantage throughout the playoffs, because that to me is the key. And when this game, Kansas City, all the incentive in the world at 9-3, the number one team out there for a wild card spot, they've got the 49ers at home. 49ers have not seen a defense quite like Kansas City, Howie and Ronnie. 49ers have yet to really have to use their passing attack to win a football game, and Coach Mariucci plainly has stated, we might need to be tested with our passing attack to get ready for the playoffs. Carter, McMillan at corner are going to absolutely drive, I think, the young wide receivers Stokes and Owens crazy on for the 49ers.
That's right, Terry. But, you know, one of the things that Marty Schottenheimer says, we got to ball up our fists. Last time they played Denver, they balled up their fists. They got after them. They're even in their first 20 plays. They're running four straight running plays. They want to run right up the middle. They want to attack these guys. And you know what? They like to barbecue
against
in Kansas.
Against the number one running
against
defense.
Right at them. And you know what? They like to barbecue. Marcus Allen said, look, you know what? I'm going to chip some ribs. I'm going to chip. The tight ends are going to chip some ribs. Look for Marcus Allen to attack these guys, help them block in the defense.
I don't think I've ever seen Pam Oliver blush.
He's speechless.
I'm going far.
Speechless.
I'm going to go ahead with it. Hey, Pam. I'll tell you what. Kansas City feels their interior three. And get this, folks. Matches up with the best pair of defensive tackles in professional football. They're also going to help out with that offensive tackle. As Ronnie pointed out, those offensive tackles, those defensive ends with chip blocks. Defensively, expect Kansas City, yes, to go with the vaunted eight-man front and play man up on the corners. And you made a good point. Kansas City wants to force the San Francisco 49ers to beat them with their passing game. That offensive line is big and physical on the run, but can they move on pass protection versus multiple blitz?
Hey, is Kansas City going to win today? Ronnie? Come on, step out on
the
that
spirit
limb.
Say that.
I know, let me tell you.
What does the spirit say?
Go ahead, say it.
I think Kansas City's got a great shot.
Who do you like? Oh, who do you like?
I think I think the Chiefs win this game.
You. All right.
Absolutely.
I'm with you, Terry.
We'll leave you out of this because we know you don't have the guts to stand up and make a statement.
I've got a book signing up here.
All right, folks. I think you look very cute with that little flower tattoo on your neck, though. You look quite nice with that. Anyway, folks, today at the Meadowlands, Andre Rison had one. It's the Tampa Bay Buccaneers against the NFC East leading New York Giants. The Giants are a game up over the Redskins, while the Bucs are just one back of the pack in the NFC Central. Now, for one family, this game is more than just a big step in the playoff race. The Giants rookie Tiki Barber and his identical twin, Tampa Bay rookie Rondé, are on opposite teams for the first time. Both have had varying degrees of success this season, but just playing in the NFL is an achievement that makes the mother proud.
It's like you have part of yourself that's, you know, somewhere else experiencing something else. And, you know, it's kind of fun. You learn, like, sort of like living two lives right now.
Growing up, we always had, you know, I had someone to play with, you know, you always had someone to do something with. And, I know, it made adjusting to everything a little bit easier.
They're friends within 20 minutes of spending time with them. They had them down cold. There was no question about it. But I'll tell you quite honestly, there are still some family members who cannot tell them apart, even after having Thanksgiving dinner at the same table with them. It's like, okay, which one is this sitting beside me now?
I think one time in college we tried to switch meetings, but it, you know, they knew.
I think it was our first year, maybe our second year, but I was like, I'm just going to go in your meeting and see if Coach Marcos notices. And I walked in there and sat down. He was like, Tiki, get the hell out of here.
That was it. I mean, we were never bad. Everybody always told us that we could be bad and do it, switch girls and everything, but we never did it.
I used to watch them in high school when they were here in the evenings talking to girls on the phone, and they would switch the phone back, the receiver back and forth between the two of them. And poor child on the other end of the line never knew that she had been speaking with both of them as opposed to one of them. They're premature babies, and they were born with some of the handicaps that premature babies have. They had some breathing problems. The last time either one of them had a seizure, they were in kindergarten. And it's been anything I want to do, I'm going to try it.
Hand off Tiki Barber. Barber off tackle. Barber still on his feet. Touchdown! And it's going to be caught, juggled, intercepted. At the 10, Barber 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. Rondé Barber 45 and knocked off his feet.
We never competed directly with one another, but I think we were competitive with each other's successes.
We were competitive not against each other, but, you know, for each other. I think we... Well, it seemed like whenever he was doing something good, I felt like I had to do something good.
It helped push us. You know, we pushed each other indirectly.
If you're asking, you know, who's going to win the 40, Tiki was a little bit quicker than Rondé. But when you take those two kids and you put them out there for what they did, you know, they were both good in the position that they played. Graduation
day. That was the happiest day in my life, and that sounds so trite, but they worked hard to keep their grades up, and they did a good job. They never lost sight of what was going to take them through the rest of their lives. The sports and the other things that came was just a means of helping them get to where they ultimately wanted to be. And when their names were called at graduation, that was, to me, a validation of them knowing exactly where they wanted to go and how to go about getting there.
Nice piece indeed.
Yeah, two good kids. You know, Mrs. Barbie did an outstanding job. Tiki threw out the first pitch at Dixie Little League for us last year down in Charlottesville, Virginia. Great kid. I think he's a game-time decision. Rondé is inactive today, and that's a big key because these two teams are a mirror image of one another. Offensively, they have the big pounding back with Allstott and Way. Way is the key to this Giants offense, but they go with the changeup with Tiki Barber. Both teams defensively want to force the opposing quarterback to beat them. It seems like it's a reoccurring theme every week. People have a suspect quarterback who can't make decisions, and they want to force that quarterback to beat them.
Bradshaw wants me to ask you, who do you like in this game?
I like Cannell. I like Cannell to make the right decisions in this game. I really do, because the Giants have better cornerbacks.
Is he quick? All right, folks, there's a lot more coming in today's show, including a look at the women who play a part every Sunday to your football experience. Weekends are showtime for cheerleaders in the NFL, but there's a lot more than meets the eye for many of these talented women. Time to find out what goes on in the secret lives of NFL cheerleaders.
Nate Newton for 1-800-COLLECT.
This is my cousin, Marvin. Say hello, Marvin.
Hello.
During the season, Marvin and I like to stay in touch. Everything is cool as long as he dials 1-800-COLLECT. It's real easy for him. And for me, it's 10 cents a minute every evening, all week long. Right, Marvin? But sometimes Marvin forgets to dial 1-800-COLLECT. And that's when he needs a little reminder. 1-800-COLLECT, 10 cents a minute, every evening, all week long.
These days, we could all use more endurance. And now I've got it.
Because new high endurance deodorant from Old Spice lasts a full 24 hours.
No one else is this strong, this long, guaranteed. Hey, no matter what you're into, now you got all the endurance you need. A full 24 hours.
Reggie! Did you eat your chunky soup?
How did you get down here? Ma!
Did you eat your chunky soup?
Yeah, Ma. Chunky beef with country vegetables. With more beef than any other soup. Lean beef, potatoes, vegetables. Chunky always hits the spot. Where'd you get that outfit?
Can't talk, gotta go. Just want to make sure you're eating good.
That's my mom.
Oh, yeah? Which one?
Campbell's Chunky Soup.
It's loaded with beef.
Have you seen the Elf? The Elf does its magic with advanced photo system film. Presto, it's loaded. Now take super shots in three different sizes. Have you seen all the Elves? From Canon.
First, she betrayed him. Now, is Kyle getting even?
I really don't think he wants to see you right now. You pathetic little parasite.
An all-new Melrose Place. Then, boys will be...
Won't I be a beautiful bride?
Girls?
You think she's a guy?
With those legs?
Guy.
An all-new Ally McBeal. It all starts Monday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Every weekend, see another classic X-Files. A classic X-Files is reborn.
On Fox 4 Late Nights. Tonight at 10:35.
Tonight, a little boy's dream comes true in an all-new holiday special, Annabelle's Wish. Then, The Simpsons celebrate the season in style. And 'tis the season for microwave accidents.
Hey, what's cooking good?
On King of the Hill, it all starts tonight at 7, 6 Central.
How to buy a minivan.
Step one.
Pick the safest minivan there is.
Ford Windstar. Step two.
Wait for the inventory closeout sale. That's when your local Ford dealer will want to clear the inventory to make room for the next shipment. Inventory closeout is the time to get the best values on Ford Windstar. Like $1,500 cash back on the only minivan to get a perfect 5-star safety rating from the government.
Step three.
Hurry into your local Ford dealer today for the inventory closeout sale. Going on now.
Meat makes the meal, and Casey Pride Meats make any meal perfect. Whether you're preparing a special holiday meal, having friends over, or a special meal for the family, Casey Pride Beef will make any meal memorable. You can depend on Casey Pride Beef for the finest flavor. It comes from 100% Midwestern grain-fed beef, and every cut is hand-trimmed of fat to just 1/8 inch. If it's leaner, better-tasting beef, guaranteed to your complete satisfaction, then it's Casey Pride Beef from Price Chopper.
You're watching Fox 4, Kansas City's 24-hour news channel.
Throughout the years, NFL cheerleaders have provided a colorful addition to the sidelines. Now, we may have grown accustomed to seeing them every weekend, but we know very little about what goes on during the week when they're not cheering. That is, until now, as we present the secret lives of the NFL cheerleaders.
My name is Nikki Hale with the Dallas Cowboys Cheerleaders. Have you ever wondered about the life of an NFL cheerleader off the sidelines? Well, you're about to find out. So let's get started.
Hello, baby!
Darkness falls, these chains will release the truth about the secret life of an NFL cheerleader.
Most people may know me as an Atlanta Falcons cheerleader, but that's just my part-time job. My full-time job is a funeral director. Come with me and I'm going to show you a little bit about my job.
Let's go! Higgins Funeral Home.
Our chapel seats a little over 300 people, but they can move their fingers. This here is a mahogany casket. Going on the first call is when we receive what is called a death call from someone, which means they have deceased. When I first started cheering, a lot of the girls wouldn't touch me because they were like, oh, you touch dead bodies, I can't touch you. I eventually want my own funeral home one day, and you know, I think they all are behind me 100%.
Back east,
Kaylin of New England teaches the children well.
Go!
To the critics who say cheerleading is an insult to feminism, get with the times. Absolutely not. It is pro-women. We are out there supporting our team in the limelight, showing how athletic and versatile we are.
Right here in Denver, two of my teammates continue to take a stand against the stereotype.
Hi, I'm Lisa Corbell, and when I'm not cheering for the Denver Broncos, I'm crunching numbers here at Maloof & Company as a CPA.
Come on, Denver!
I love working with numbers, and the fact that people meet me and they say, I can't believe you're a CPA, that's insanity. Well, it's not really.
When I'm not cheering at Mile High, I'm hitting the books at the University of Denver College of Law.
Measures giving reasonable assurance that all lawyers conform.
Off the field, wow, I'm in law school, I have a family, two little boys and a husband, and I keep busy.
If you're looking for a good attorney, how about Julie from the Jacksonville Roar?
I'm on the law and the law one. I'm on the law and the law one.
I really enjoy courtroom work because it is a challenge, and you have to use your brain to come up with all these arguments and make your position as strong as you possibly can.
A couple of Washington women are next.
Hi, my name's Janae. On Sundays, I'm a Washington Redskinette. Monday through Friday, my life is here.
I am the congressman's scheduler. My job is to make sure his schedule is together, make sure it's straight, make sure he's where he's supposed to be.
One of my teammates is Holly Edwards. Her job is so top secret, I can't even tell you what she does.
Thanks, Janae. I too am a Redskinette, but Monday through Friday I work for Tracor, which is the defense contractor. It's really top secret, so if you were to come in, we'd have to shoot you.
Athena of the St. Louis Rams Cheerleaders has taken the Show Me State slogan to heart.
I'm an intelligent woman. I have a bachelor's degree in sign language interpreting, so I have the best of both worlds. So do you think that's an insult to feminism?
That's the door from St. Louis. Let's send it back to Celeste.
In Oakland, there's always a commitment to excellence.
I got a letter from the Raiders advertisement. It said they're going to have a Raiders tryout. So I just went on and tried out. My husband encouraged me, and I didn't think I could really do it because I was deaf. I couldn't hear the music. And I hope the public realizes that they can do anything that they try as well, as long as they just have confidence in themselves.
Hi, I'm Leah Goodwin, Dallas Cowboys cheerleader. On Sunday, you'll find me on the sidelines cheering for the boys, but during the week, you'll find me here as a financial service representative. A few simple steps toward a secure future is your retirement plan. Well, you have my card, and if you need anything, just give me a call.
Okay. I will. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Well, that's it from the Rockies, but remember, the women of the NFL have something to say. Bye-bye.
Oh, say, can you see?
Obviously, the largest myth about cheerleaders is that it's they're bimbos.
Being a cheerleader and being as well-rounded as we are should just break that stereotype.
And the home of the brave.
And you know, I have heard you guys give many a speech, and I've never heard you guys talk about the kind of role that cheerleaders have played in your various on-field success as Howie leaves, because he knew I was coming right to him first. Why would Howie leave?
I don't know. Well, Leah, I got this card. Leah wanted me to pass that card on to you. So there's the card.
All righty.
Liam, Kansas City male cheerleader.
It's almost game time, so stay right where you are. Right now, it's time for the Pizza Hut deliveries, where we show who's been bringing the winning play for their team. The Packers' Brett Favre and New York's John Hall are leading the pack with 6 game-winning plays. 3 others are in second with 5. And we'll come back and talk a little more football.
I hope so.
When we come back.
prove that Energizer lasts over 15% longer than Duracell in these camcorders. Here's Energizer management trainee Jeff Mackin.
My Jeff, and it's bye-bye, bunny.
Now,
ever sat in your boss's chair?
Yeah.
Okay. Which battery lasts over 15% longer in these camcorders?
Energizer.
Next time, Pink.
Welcome to Packer Bell Service and Support. How can I help you?
Hi, it's Kelly Mitchell.
And who's that I hear?
Jamie's a bit cranky. Listen, I'm having a little trouble with my computer.
Okay, well, one problem at a time. Put Jamie on.
At Packard Bell Service and Support, we can solve just about any problem. Packard Bell, the computer the world comes home to. Featuring the Intel Pentium 2 processor.
Do I hear $2,000 for a date with supermodel Jennifer? $2,000.
Is your dandruff sending the wrong signals?
Sold to number 10 for $2,000.
Get Celsin Power. Doctors recommend Celsin Blue number 1. So don't send the wrong signals. Get Celsin Power.
After 30 years of dirt and 30 years of cleaning, a Moen faucet with the new LifeShine finish will look as good as it did 30 years ago. LifeShine by Moen. Buy it for looks. Buy it for life.
Let's go!
Vacation travelers know that when it comes to renting a car, there's really only one place to go. National Car Rental. Especially if you're going to the happiest place on Earth. Because as the official car rental company of Disneyland in Southern California, National gets you in your car and on the road fast. For a family vacation you'll never forget. So what are you waiting for? Let's go to Disneyland with National Car Rental.
Tonight, a little boy's dream comes true in an all-new holiday special.
It's our secret.
Annabelle's Wish. Then, the Simpsons celebrate the season in style.
It's us yuppies,
huh? I'm really more of a slacker.
And 'tis the season for love, celebration, and microwave accidents.
What's cooking, good Lord?
On King of the Hill, followed by a new X-Files with a classic twist. It all starts tonight at 7, 6 Central.
And a reminder, January 18th is a day for an Olympic-type preview as the NHL All-Star Game pits the North American All-Stars against the world. Hey, folks, Dallas Cowboys, real quickly, should we stick a fork in them? Are they dead?
Well, you got to look at the injury situation. They lost Emmitt Smith. Now they lost Deion Sanders. They're going to have some problems down the stretch, but I don't know if they're done. But you have to say that they have a chance of winning these next three games.
At best, I think they'll play the role of spoiler. And, you know, I have to ask Terry, is Barry going to be coach of the year now?
He's not going to be my coach of the year, but he's still a great guy. I don't care
what happens.
All
right, folks, we're going to send some of you out to your games. The rest we'll bring you back here in a moment.
It takes all three of these Sanders to do everything the sandstorm does. It's three Sanders for the price of one. The Sandstorm, built by Black & Decker.
Boys, boys, check it out. Coach, coach.
Check it out.
Dawson, nice tattoo. You've been traded to Miami.
Gonna be a while? Grab a Snickers.
What do you think?
Fish.
Let's try the fish.
It's part of the job. I got this pulling a 360 stale fish. I got this doing a 900 nose grab. Got this on a backflip muting the putt. But when I pull the fakie alley-oop McTwist Indy 540, I got this. On the very day, I swear. I got hair on my back, too. Cool, huh?
PlayStation.
And what did you do this weekend, Tommy?
I have been to the edge and back.
Excuse me?
Introducing the Edge Pizza from Pizza Hut.
Pizza is about topping.
Crust is your safety net.
The Edge has no outer crust.
The Edge is toppings right to the edge.
Toppings right to the edge.
Take the Edge.
I stand like
let go of your crust, my friend.
Brother.
Sister.
I have been to the Edge and back. Join me.
16 pieces of pure toppings. Have you been to the Edge?
These are the Schmitz of Munich. This is their new Porsche Boxster. In order to drive it Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, Mr. Schmidt has agreed to assume dog-washing responsibilities. And Mrs. Schmidt, in return for Tuesday, Thursday, and the coveted Saturday, has to make Mr. Schmidt's favorite Pinkelwurst three times a week. On Sundays, they share the Boxster. Of course, this leaves out young Dieter, who has just earned his driver's license. As in all domestic disputes, it's the children who suffer most. The Boxster. Once again, there is no substitute.
Tuesday, join Kelsey Grammer, Roseanne, Tim Conway, Sybil Shepherd, Keenan Ivory Wayans, Candace Bergen, and more for the funniest and most touching comedy event of the year.
I've eaten so much roughage that I'm beginning to pass wicker furniture.
The American Comedy Honors, Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Time now for the Erickson countdown to kickoff. Up next, it's a battle of powerhouses as the 49ers take their 11-game win streak into Kansas City to take on the Chiefs. Pat Summerall and John Madden are set to bring you all the action, so let's take you on out to Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City.
Throughout the years, the San Francisco 49ers have been blessed with quality and depth at quarterback. The Kansas City Chiefs, on the other hand, a team searching for that final piece, have looked to these ex-49ers to lead them to the next level. This season, Elvis Gerbach was beginning to look like that leader until his injury threatened Kansas City's playoff drive. But the Chiefs have not lost a beat and look to prove their mettle against the 49ers. Arrowhead Stadium, a sea of red. The national anthem. There is no sight quite like it. Both teams, the 49ers and the Chiefs, clad in red, the crowd clad in red. Steve Mariucci, the 49ers head coach, also. And here in Kansas City, we're seeing two of the elite teams in the NFL. Let's talk about the 49ers first, John. They have the best record in the league, despite the fact that in game number one, they lost Jerry Rice and Steve Young. How have they been able to do it?
I think that Steve Mariucci has done an excellent job. The first thing that they did is they played great defense, and they have nine out of their starting 11 defensive players have been in Pro Bowl, so they have good people there. They play good special teams. And on offense, they've kind of gone to a more conservative approach. You know, they're running the ball more. They're spreading the ball around. And I think a lot of their success has been that, and also been trying to keep Steve Young healthy.
And, you know, the Chiefs have sort of patterned themselves after the 49ers. They are one of the elite teams in the NFL as well. And how have they been able to do it?
The same way, with a great organization, with a good coaching staff. And you look at the Chiefs, and you don't see a lot of stars or a lot of superstars. And you say, how do they do it? They play well as a team. They play good, solid offense. On defense, they have a great deal of team speed. And then they have excellent special teams.
So two of the best, the very best. And coming up, it's the San Francisco 49ers and the Kansas City Chiefs from Arrowhead Stadium. John and I will be back for the opening kickoff when Fox NFL Sunday continues after these messages from your local station.
You're watching Fox NFL Sunday.
There are a lot of things out there that will make your heart beat faster. This is one of them. Jeep Cherokee. With full-time select track four-wheel drive and quadrilink suspension, it's sure to quicken anybody's pulse. Lease a 98 Cherokee for $259 a month and get all this at no extra charge. Check one out at your Jeep dealer.
Introducing Nintendo Score 64 and win at Taco Bell. Just peel the coin off the lid. Score 64, and you could win an N64 system, cash, or millions of other great prizes. And who knows who'll win the Porsche Boxster. It's Score 64 and win. Only at Taco Bell.
A lot of industry experts told us that the passenger side was the best place to add a third door. We got still more advice, insisting that the driver's side was the only logical choice. But as you can see, we let it all go right in one ear and out the other. Introducing the new Dodge Ram Quad Cab. The rules have changed.
Thanks, Kansas City, for your generous support of education. One for the Children this year raised over $1 million for area schools. Great job.
You're watching Fox NFL Sunday.
We're back at Erickson Stadium where we're down to the final seconds of the game and it's still tied. The kick's high. And
Erickson mobile phones. Catch the excitement.
And now, the Erickson countdown continues.
Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City, and it's a packed house. As you look at the playoff picture, the 49ers can clinch a first round bye with a win or a giant loss, and Kansas City can clinch a playoff berth with a couple of other conditions being met.
It's time, baby! It's
time! Vanover back deep for Tommy Thompson's kickoff. Thompson, who kicks with his right foot barefoot. It's kind of cool in Kansas City, but apparently it doesn't hurt him. Vanover, who is big and fast, has had some problems fumbling lately on kickoff returns, but he is dangerous. Vanover in the corner of the field at about the 7. Out to almost the 30, maybe the 28. Let's look at the Kansas City offense. Led by 10-year veteran Rich Gannon, who is 2-1 this season as a starter. A good offensive line in front of him, Criswell and Parker, the tackles. Zott and Shields, the guards, and Tim Grunhard, the anchor at center. Greg Hill and Donnell Bennett will open at fullback in place of Kimball Anders. Risen, Dawson, and Popson are the receivers. First down, Kansas City. From their own 28. On first down, Greg Hill. Here is that number one San Francisco defense. The front four, Dolman, Stubblefield, Bryant Young, and Kevin Green. The three linebackers, Norton, Plummer, and Woodall. Plummer in the middle. And the secondary, Darnell Walker, Merton Hanks, Tim McDonald is back, and Rod Woodson. Second and 7. Hill got 3 on the first carry. Hill again.
You know, it's interesting. One of the things the Kansas City Chiefs are going to do is run right at the middle. We talked about the strength of the 49er defense is right here. Here's Bryant Young. Here's Dana Stubblefield. That's the strength. Kansas City says that they're going to run right at their strength. They're going to go right up the middle, run right at those two tackles. That time, the Kansas City Chief offensive line blocked those two tackles.
Third and 1. 3 wide receivers. Donnell Bennett gets the carry and gets the first down to the 40.
You know, it's interesting. Sometimes, you know, your teams say, we're going to do this or we're going to do that. And you think, oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, you take, we talked about the 49er defense being so good. And to me, their strength really starts with Dana Stubblefield and Bryant Young. These two guys right here in the middle, it starts in there with that middle, and they are going to go, and they're going to run right at it. I mean, here's Bryant Young. They get him stood up, and they get right by him, and they get the first down. I think Bryant Young is one of the best defensive tackles in all of football.
This is Hill on first down, across midfield, and another first down. Stopped by Woodson.
Now, the Kansas City Chiefs are one of those teams, and Marty Schottenheimer is the coach. It kind of goes into every game to prove something. You know, it's kind of like, you know, we're the underdog. These guys, you know, they've been in Super Bowls. They say they're better than us. You know, they say, you know, the NFC is better. And he makes, you know, kind of us against them mentality up for every game.
Plus going against the best defensive unit in football, perhaps.
And I think this is a great barometer for both of these teams to see where they stand.
Gannon will throw. He's chased by Green. Pass complete to Bennett, who only gets about a yard. Kansas City is doing it against a dominating San Francisco defense.
Yeah, and you say, how did the San Francisco 49ers get where they are today? And I think it starts right there. That's the number one thing. It starts with their defense. And you look out and how many categories within that defense that they're ranked number one.
That's pretty impressive right there. Well, you got that many number ones by your name. That's pretty good.
And they've been playing impressively.
Second and long. Greg Hill gets only a couple.
I think they finally figured out what they're trying to do there at that running game is run up the middle, and they got a little more stout in there. And you're going to see, here you see these two tackles here. They're going to start standing things up, and they're going to start plugging up here in the middle more. You see, here they've won that battle on the line of scrimmage. You see, they try and get movement on that. They didn't get any movement. In fact, the back ran right into one of his own guys.
On third down, they need seven for a first. Gannon going deep. Got a man. Incomplete. That's good coverage. Andre Rison.
And that's it. Anytime you get Tyrone Drakeford at corner.
Yep.
And that's what the 49ers do in nickel. And you get this situation, that's where they're going to go. If there's anyone that's susceptible to getting beaten deep, it's Tyrone Drakeford in this secondary. Andre Rison is the top receiver in the Kansas City Chiefs, so they take their best receiver against the guy that is most susceptible.
And that pass was a little bit short.
If he throws that another 6 inches or so, that's a touchdown.
That's a touchdown. You're right. Aguiar's punt to Owazike. And the coverage is excellent. The Chiefs take him down, led by Tony Richardson at about the 12-yard line. And San Francisco will go to work from there.
It's the drive to succeed that makes a champion. Pitching in, fighting the battle as a team. Using heart, not just mind and body. Giving whatever it takes. Going the distance for the fan. And loving every minute of it. Southwest Airlines is a proud sponsor of the NFL and the official airline of Super Bowl 32.
See the world run. Run, world, run. Run. See Texaco run. Visualize. Hypothesize, explore, and relentlessly search and find the energy the world needs to run. Run, world, run. Texaco, a world of energy.
It is 180 degrees from expected. It is a leather-trimmed interior, available heated front seats, and an Infiniti 10-speaker audio system. The new Chrysler Town & Country LXI, built on the belief that great cars appeal to a more passionate side. And now, it's available with $1,000 cash back or a very special low lease rate. Chrysler, engineered to be great cars.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of the Super Bowl. By Chrysler, engineered to be great cars. By Texaco, a world of energy. And by Energizer, long-lasting Energizer batteries keep going and going.
Arrowhead Stadium, not an empty seat anywhere. The 49ers road record 5-1, the Kansas City home record 5-0. Something's got to give. Garrison Hurst around the corner. Picked up good yardage. Let's look at the San Francisco offense led by Steve Young. 13-year career, 64.7 completion percentage, the highest of all time. Big offensive line in front of him. Deese Brown, Dahlman, Gogan, and Strafford. Two guards particularly big. Garrison Hurst, William Floyd, Stokes and Owens, the wide receivers, and Brent Jones, the tight end. Hurst got six at second and four. Two tight ends set up for the 49ers. Here's Steve Young. Incomplete for Owens. Slightly behind him, but he could have caught it. Kansas City defense. Williams, Phillips, and Booker, the front three. Outstanding linebackers, Derek Thomas, Davis, Edwards, and Simmons, acquired from the Packers. Hasty and Carter, the cornerbacks, Woods and Reggie Tung, the secondary. Third and four.
You know, at one time, the strength of this defense was really the secondary, but I think this year it's changing to the strength of this Kansas City defense, maybe being the linebackers.
Young catches him off balance with a quick count. And down he goes, taken down by Dan Williams.
That's the thing the Chiefs wanted to do, is stop the run, get him in long yardage, and then tee off on Steve Young. You know, for years we had heard, you know, you play the 49ers, you have to control Steve Young, you have to stop the pass. The Kansas City Chiefs defense is playing this game to stop the run, put Steve Young in passing situations, and make Steve Young beat him with the forward pass.
Thompson back to punt, standing in his own end zone, to Vanover, back for the Chiefs. Not his best effort. Can be, should be returned, and is returned. Kamara Vanover inside the 49er 40, and out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. A 38-yard punt, 12-yard return by Vanover.
Hey, there's all kinds of action on that punt, wasn't there? There was action on the sideline. There was action on the field. They just kept playing.
Marty Schottenheimer. His team's always thoroughly prepared.
Look at what they do to those gunners. You know, those outside guys on cover. They just maul them. I mean, they double team them. One starts and works on them, and the other goes on them, and they just do about anything within the rule. I don't even know they're ever
separated
the rule.
Yeah.
It took two to separate them, plus another guy was coming in. Yeah. I think it darn near took three to separate them.
First and 10, Kansas City at the 49er 38. Hill knocked backwards and recovered.
They got in there. Bryant Young got the penetration, but Hill was able to gain a little more yardage after that. If you watch Bryant Young, he's going to be right here. Now, you want to keep these guys on this side of the line of scrimmage. When you get back in on this side, you're going to win that battle. Now watch number 97 there. You see, right there, he slithers through. Right there, he gets the penetration there, and that was the one that got Greg Hill.
And Dolman finally took him down. Gain of 1.5. Here's Gannon back to throw. Over the head of Norton and Donnell Bennett.
You know, that is the way to pick up a defensive line stunt, Pat. On that one, they had a defensive line stunt with Bryant Young and Chris Dolman. And you're going to watch. Bryant Young goes down. Chris Dolman comes across here and falls over Bryant Young. Then if that happens there, you don't have to block. You see him go down? Watch Dolman goes right over the top of him. So they get a double dip right in the middle, which should have given Gannon a little more time to throw that one.
Third and 7. Maybe 8. Gannon back to throw again. 49ers blitz. He read it and got it outside to Andre Rison.
And he's the perfect guy to get it to, Spider-Man. After he catches what he does to Spider-Man, first he twirls that ball and then does the Spider-Man. But if you're going to get the ball, who's his favorite receiver? Right now it's Andre Rison. They have good protection there. They pick up the blitz, and he gets the one-on-one coverage out there against Darnell Walker. There's Darnell Walker playing man-to-man on Andre Rison. That's a form of that fade stop.
Yeah.
You know, you just start running up and stop anywhere you want to.
First down at about the 17. Gannon doesn't see Kevin Green coming, but he got away from him. He gets it to Greg Hill. And Hill gets positive yardage. That good play by Gannon.
You know, we talk about Steve Young being such a good runner. Rich Gannon is the same type of thing. When he came out of college at Delaware, he was timing like a 4.5 40. In fact, the New England Patriots drafted him, and they were going to play him in another position. That they said, we don't know if we're going to play a running back, wide receiver, defensive back. That was enough for Gannon. He said, I'm not going to play here.
I'm not going there.
And he forced a trade to Minnesota.
Second and five. Hill again.
Yeah, I'm really impressed with this offensive line of the Kansas City Chiefs. You know, we talked about Zott and Grunhart and Shields inside, but even Glenn Parker and Jeff Criswell, you just watch it how they're controlling this area right here. This is where they're going to run. So these guys have to control these guys to be able to get the ball in there. Watch how they do it. You see, they take off, they catch him, they pin him. Ted Popson, the tight end, gets a block also, but they didn't get any penetration the 49er defense did.
First and goal at the six. Gannon looks. Incomplete. Gonzalez was in the game in place of Greg Hill. And that was for whom the pass was intended.
Was a local guy, yeah. Tony Gonzalez went to the University of California. Came out after his junior year. Remember, he played on the basketball team at Cal. It went to the NCAA.
And played well.
I remember watching him in basketball. Hadn't seen him play football. And I said, geez, just watching this guy play basketball, I would draft him as a number one tight end.
Marcus Allen is in the slot to the left. Touchdown. Rising.
That's his Spider-Man move on the goalpost he puts. He's going to go put Spider-Man right on the goalpost.
Stuck to the goalpost.
Andre Rison, you know, he takes a lot of things that say that he's not this and he's not that, but I'll tell you what he is. He's a heck of a good football player, a hard practice player, and a great competitor. Watch him. Here he is. Anytime you get this matchup up here, here's Andre Rison here. They know that they have one-on-one in a press coverage. He just gets to the outside, gets a step, and now Gannon can lead it not over, not only up over, but to the outside.
Stojanovic, extra point, makes it 7-0 Kansas City. The Chiefs over the 49ers early.
Some decisions are harder than others. The Chrysler Sebring LXI Coupe or the Sebring Limited Convertible. For the passionate side, fully independent suspension, speed-sensitive steering, multi-valve V6, and a luxurious leather-trimmed interior. The practical side? Lease the convertible from just $299 a month. And on the coupe, get $1,000 cash back and luxurious leather at no charge. Some decisions are easier than others. Chrysler, engineered to be great cars.
Save $100 on professional installation. So what are you waiting for? DSS system prices are lower than ever. It's available at your participating retailer today.
Disney's Flubber has arrived, and McDonald's has a surprise for you.
Thanks.
Just supersize any extra value meal and get a coupon for an adult admission to Flubber at a kid's price.
Hey, Dad, best seats in the house.
Mom's calling Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Our car is sick.
Enterprise will arrange to pick you up.
Wow!
Drive you to our place and get you on your way.
Everybody loves to be picked up.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
The X-Files presents a classic horror tale.
This fly has legs
growing out of his mouth.
An all-new X-Files tonight at 9, 8 Central.
Back at Arrowhead Stadium, Kansas City 7. 49ers nothing. Stojanovic about set to kick off as Andre Rison just scored for the Chiefs.
That's not a bad place to go when you get Andre Rison out there in that situation. with man-to-man coverage, and the man-to-man coverage is tight coverage, and it's an ex-teammate. It was Darnell Walker. Yeah. You know, they played together in Atlanta, so Andre Rison knows what he can do, could do, and should do, and did it.
Stojanovic, number 10, Chuck Levy back deep for the 49ers. 7-0 Kansas City. Levy. Flag on the play as Levy gets it out to the 40, lost the football. Chiefs are saying they have it. The 49ers are saying he was down.
And the official, more importantly, is saying that he's down. The official was pointing to the ground.
Gary Lane.
Remember, there is a penalty, and I'm sure the penalty is going to be against the return team.
A good return by Levy.
Usually you don't see on kickoff coverage, when you see a penalty flag, you don't see a lot of it against the coverage team. It usually is, you know, either holding like we see here, or clipping, or hitting from the back, or those types of things. Hitting in the back above the waist, hitting in the back below the waist,
holding,
those kinds of things.
On the return team, 10-yard penalty, first down.
7-0 Kansas City over San Francisco.
It begins with a step away from the known and a step towards the unknown. It will take you to ports halfway around the world and into uncharted waters deep inside yourself. Above all, it will demand your honor, your courage, and your commitment. It's your journey. Start it in the right direction. Call 1-800-USA-NAVY. Let the journey begin.
I mean it.
I know.
I'm not coming back. I'm serious. It's final.
Go ahead.
Across America, more people use Cellular One than any other cellular service.
Now I get to this bridge, I'm not turning around. I mean it.
Just hold this and you know you're going to get a close shave.
Remington introduces the new shape in shaving.
The angle to the face, just right.
Can't believe I'm in love with an electric, but look at this shave.
Remington's new dual microscreen, built to shave incredibly close.
And they guarantee it.
It is a deliberate departure from the norm. 180 degrees from expected. Spacious leather-trimmed interior. Available heated front seats. And now it ties as J.D. Power and Associates' most appealing minivan. The new Chrysler Town & Country LXI. Built on the belief that great cars appeal to a more passionate side. Chrysler. Engineered to be great cars.
Olympic hopefuls gather for a special weekend finale in the Primestar Skate International Champions Series. Coverage begins next, here on Fox.
Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. Pat Summerall with John Madden. 7-0 Kansas City leads the 49ers. Steve Young surveys the defense. That's William Floyd. And right now from McDonald's game break, let's return to James Brown at the Fox Television Center in Hollywood.
Pat, Washington is one game behind the Giants in the East. Game opening drive, play action for Roger Larry Bowie. Bowie back first game after two out with an injury. Washington on top by a touchdown. Back to Kansas City, Pat Summerall and John Madden.
Back for those teams that are still involved in the playoff hunt. Every game is a must game from here on in. Young, look out. Flag on the play.
I think the whistle blew before the ball was snapped, Pat.
And Steve Young's hurt.
Yeah, and that play shouldn't have even happened. I think it has to be a penalty against the offense illegal movement because the official on this side did blow his whistle and he waved it off and no one stopped. Especially no one stopped from that other side that hit Steve Young from his right side, which being a left-hander is his backside.
Yeah, he hit him right in the back.
You're going to see Steve Young turning to our side here, to his left, not feeling that pressure coming from the backside, And did he get loaded upon? Much Anthony Davis, number 50, comes from his backside and just unloads with his helmet right in Steve Young's back. But again, the official stopped that play, Pat, before the ball was snapped.
And Derek Dees also was shaken up.
Number 40
on the play.
Personal foul, roughing the passer after the whistle. Number 50 in the defense, 15 yards, first down.
Yeah, see what they're saying is when William Floyd moved, then that stops because it's illegal motion, and the officials did stop the play, so there was no play at all. So Anthony Davis kept coming after the whistle blew, the whistle that stopped the play. You see, you're going to see right now the whistle is blowing. There is no play. You see, Steve Young is just standing there. Anthony Davis comes from his blind side and hits it from the back. Now, I will say the guy that blew the whistle,
personal
the official blew the official.
Unnecessary roughness, not roughing the passer. First down.
Yeah, because there was no passer, because there was no play, because the whistle blew before the ball was even snapped.
Steve Young just standing there, hitting the back. That was a whipsaw. And Derek Dees, Derek Dees was taken out on the play ball also.
And I was saying that the official that blew the whistle was down here on this side. Anthony Davis came from the opposite side.
Now Frank Pollock.
49ers have had more problem at that offensive left tackle than any position on their team.
Yep. That's Garrison Hurst. And very little gain. Stopped by Tom Barnt.
Tom Barnt is an interesting story. He was an offensive lineman. He was an offensive lineman for the Chiefs, and it didn't look like he was going to make it as an offensive lineman. And Gunther Cunningham was a defensive coordinator. Looked at him on defense and said, you know, if you're not going to keep him over there, if you're not going to play him over there, I will play him. So he's playing defense, a guy who started out as an offensive lineman.
Second and long, is it Hurst again? Out of bounds, just outside the 30, about the 32.5 yard line.
One thing that's very impressive about this Kansas City defense is the way that they pursue and gang tackle. I mean, if you had to say, you know, at linebacker, you know, who has the most speed in the league, I would think would be the Kansas City Chiefs.
They make the field look smaller.
Yeah, because they just fly to it. I mean, you know, Derek Thomas for years was one of the fastest guys in football, and now Anthony Davis is faster than him, and so is Donnie Edwards, the other two linebackers.
Frank Pollock now remains at left tackle. Three wide receivers.
This is where Steve Young likes to try and find Brent Jones.
He also likes to run
and find a first down.
He was hit after he slid, and no flag is thrown. Donnie Edwards,
you know,
got the shot and got up and started to put his wave his arms in the air like I didn't do anything.
Yeah, well, Steve Young, that doesn't make a lot of sense to him, because they tell you if you go head first, they can tackle you. If you go feet first, supposedly you are giving up. The ball is going to be spotted right there where you go down, and they can't touch you.
That's feet first.
And he says every time he goes feet first, he said that's supposed to be the rule. He does it, and they still come in and clobber him.
First down. There's a guy who'll know where the markers are, Steve Young. This is Garrison Hurst, and he's got a blocker and some room. Hurst in the Chiefs territory. The Chiefs come out of there with the football somehow. Reggie Tung took the ball away from Garrison Hurst. And the 49ers are saying he was down.
I know it. They're all spotting. They're saying that he was down or out of bounds because it happened right there on the sideline. William Floyd, better watch out.
Yep.
You don't want to get too animated around those officials.
And Carter better back away a little bit, too.
Yeah, but especially when you start making movements like that, you're close to an official. You can't touch an official. You don't want to be making a lot of movements around him. They're having a crew conference now. You see two officials and the referee that were involved in the play are talking to the referee. Other officials are trying to keep them away.
The ball is ruled down by contact. First down.
Well, we can look again.
Well, there's Garrison Hurst, and you see right there, as he goes down, the ball comes out. I don't know what down by contact has to do. The ball is already out. That's a poor decision there. Another reason why I think we need instant replay. I mean, the ball is out. The ball is still in bounds. When Reggie Tongue picks it up, that should be the Chiefs' ball. It's a fumble, and it's a recovery by the Chiefs.
But that's not the message that takes place on the field. It's the 49er ball.
Yeah, and that's why we do need instant replay. I mean, we have instant replay. We just have to use it. Everyone sees it. They see it here in the stadium. They see it in the luxury boxes. They see it in the coaching boxes. You see it at home. And the only guys that can't look at it are the officials.
First down, San Francisco at the Chief 45. Young to J.J. Stokes inside the 25. And again, the ball came loose, but he was down.
That's an interesting play. It's off that bootleg where you get the backs going one way and you try and get flow, and then you throw back against it. You see what you do is you get the backs coming this way to get a flow and hold this linebacker. Then you go back and you throw the ball out to this side. See, now watch the flow of the backs go to the right. Then he just stands up and knows that he can hold that linebacker to get that ball in that slant.
Derek Deese is back. This is William Floyd. Just shy of the 20, about the 21. Brent Jones was the tight end. Clark had been there.
Hey, you know, the 49ers got a couple of breaks on this drive, and one wasn't a break. You know, the penalty when Anthony Davis hit Steve Young, that was 110 yards, and then after Garrison Hurst fumbled, it should have been the Chiefs' ball, and the 49ers, you know, got to keep it. So they do have a couple things going for them.
In the play against Steve Young, you didn't think that should have been a penalty?
No. It should have been a penalty, but that, I mean, they got 10 yards of penalty.
Right.
Oh, no, I thought that should have been. I mean, there's just because an offensive guy moves doesn't give you a free shot.
Doesn't give you a free shot at the quarterback. False start against the 49ers.
5-yard penalty. Still second down.
Last time it was William Floyd. This time it was his right guard, Kevin Gogan. And this place, Arrowhead Stadium, is one of the toughest stadiums to hear in for offensive linemen. I guess it could be offensive ends or backs or anyone, but
I guess
you just always jump on the side of linemen. You know, you don't make an excuse for William Floyd, oh, bar none, but when big old Gogan does, you make an excuse for him and say, oh, it's loud, oh, big old Gogan can't hear.
The handoff is to Hurst, and Garrison Hurst inside the 20.
Big old Gogan got his five back on that one, Pat.
Did he ever?
Because they said, you know, that big old Gogan moves, so now they said, well, let's give you a chance. So they run right behind Kevin Gogan. Watch him. He's the right guard. He's going to come down here, and that's going to create the hole that Garrison Hurst is going to run in. Watch Gogan come down there, get that movement there, create that hole, and get those 5 yards back that he just gave up.
Gogan and William Floyd both got the good blocks. Young outside to Brent Jones, who is hit hard.
Even the most experienced do it, don't they? Brent Jones runs a nine-yard pattern, and you know that's one of the things on third down. Brent Jones should know that. Steve Young should know it. Brent Jones been in the league 11 years. You can't run a pattern short of the first down, because if you get it, you still have to kick anyway, so why even throw it?
It brings on the field goal unit, and it's a point well taken. Why put it in the air and take a chance of an interception if you're not going to get a first down? Anderson hits the field goal, and the 49ers get on the board. The Chiefs still lead 7-3.
Presenting the play that made the difference. Brought to you by Wendy's, where freshness is what makes the difference. In week 5, the Bucks trailed the Cardinals late. Stay tuned to see if the Bucks had an ace up their sleeve.
He's going to take it in and score. Down the sidelines, he's in there.
Happy holidays, Dave.
Same to you, Red.
I think you'll find this spicy chicken sandwich spicier than yours.
Not bad. But remember this?
Wendy's spicy chicken is seasoned with Dave's own blend of pepper and spices for that spicy hit you crave.
So?
So, you got any more in the bag?
Maybe.
Yeah. All right.
Wendy's spicy chicken sandwich. It can warm up anybody.
Hey, jingle bells, jingle.
Now's time.
Fourth quarter, man. Let's go.
In the fourth quarter, the Buccaneers proved they were for real by capping a comeback victory with his picture-perfect pass. A huge win for Tampa Bay and testament to pewter power.
From the beginning, car design started from the outside. But at the Chrysler Corporation, we like to look at things differently. So one day we asked,
why not start with the people and work out?
It started a revolution called Cab Forward. Cars that are roomier, more interesting to look at, more fun to drive. And now that we've built more than 2 million of them, it's time to ask, why not keep pushing it? At the Chrysler Corporation, it's how we build great cars and great trucks.
In a place where animals talk and a little boy can't, a magical thing is about to happen. The holiday special, Annabelle's Wish, tonight at 7, 6 Central.
Merry Christmas!
Back at Arrowhead Stadium, what a sight this is. Sold out, everybody dressed in red, or just about everybody in something red, including the cars in the parking lot, the tents.
Yeah, great tailgating here. Everything about football on Sunday at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City is pretty doggone good.
Amarik Vanover at the 7. To the 30. Brent Jones over on the sideline just caught that 9-yard pass and hurt his finger in the process.
And I'm sure that, you know, Brent Jones is thinking about that, knowing when it's third down, he has to run his pattern to a depth that he's going to get a first down. Now it seems like you're so used to seeing receivers today wearing gloves. Brent Jones doesn't wear gloves, and I don't think Ted Popson wears gloves either.
Merton Hanks has got a broken finger. So that's not a glove, that's a bandage.
A big old cast. That's a big old cast under that bandage, too.
Gannon back to Marcus Allen. And Marcus Allen for a couple, maybe three.
Marcus Allen was talking about Barry Sanders yesterday and says, you know, as long as he's been in this game, Marcus Allen, he says he never has ceased to be amazed by a guy like Barry Sanders the way he runs.
He said these guys, as Edwards leaving, Marcus said the people trying to tackle him are professional athletes, the best athletes in the world.
Yeah, paid professionals.
And they don't touch him.
And he says it's like trying to tackle Barry Sanders. He says it's like grabbing a bar of soap in a bathtub.
This is Marcus Allen. First down. Stubblefield ran him down. Marcus wouldn't like that. Say Dana Stubblefield ran him down, would he? 7-3. Chiefs lead.
Tell the truth, Jeff, or it's bye-bye, bunny. Which battery lasts over 15% longer in these camcorders? Duracell or Energizer?
Energizer.
Next time, pink.
Don't worry, baby. You can't walk now. You gotta get out.
Not.
Gonna be a while? Grab a Snickers.
Posting completion stress disorder.
Hey, look! Can we go, Mom? Can we go?
Disney's Flubber has arrived. And McDonald's has a surprise for you.
Thanks. Come again.
Just supersize any extra value meal. And with America's favorite fries, get a coupon for an adult admission to Flubber at a kid's price. You've never seen anything like this before.
Hey, Dad, best seats in the house.
Tuesday, Fox presents a star-studded salute to six of television's most popular comic geniuses and the funniest and most touching comedy event of the year. The American Comedy Honors, Tuesday at 8, 7 Central, right here on Fox. Art Woodson apparently just got a stinger of some kind.
Yeah, it looks like if you watch here, watch his left shoulder right there as Marcus Allen makes a cut on him. Looks like he just knocks that 28 on that shoulder a little askew. And then, you know, could have one of those stinger things, but I'll bet he'll be back in there in the next couple plays.
Word on Donnie Edwards is that he sprained his thumb and he's having it wrapped or rewrapped.
Or x-rayed.
That's Marcus Allen. And there is nothing for Marcus.
Marcus Allen is an amazing guy.
Yeah,
you know, when you think of a guy playing the game as long as Marcus Allen has at this position and, you know, for 16 years and playing it so well. And I know Marty Schottenheimer says yesterday that he thinks that he's still the best short yardage and goal line runner in all of football. And to me, those have always been the most important yards. I mean, you like first down's nice, second down's okay, but third down, short yardage, goal line, those are the most important downs you ever have.
And for Marcus Allen, no mention of retirement. Gannon. A lot of time in the pocket as Rich Gannon is stripped off.
Way too much time.
Yeah.
I mean, that's excellent pass protection by the Kansas City Chiefs. We talked about how this was going to be a match and a game in the trenches and all those things. Kansas City's offensive line, this group right here, is winning that battle so far. Look at the time that Gannon has. I mean, he looks to his right, he looks to his left. He even brings his head down to look and see where the pass rush is, doesn't see anything, and brings his head back up.
Did you see how well they control those two tackles?
Well, that's what they have to do. I mean, they have to control Bryant Young and Dana Stubblefield, and they're doing it both the run and the pass.
Here's Allen. Close to a first down, but didn't get it. Steve Young, who took a wallop in the back earlier. He still looks a little gingerly stepping around.
I think he could, because it was one of those things that, again, it was no play, and it looked like he was hit by Anthony Davis just as he started to relax.
Didn't expect the hit.
Oh, and you know, couldn't feel it, didn't see it, didn't know anything about it.
Yeah.
This is going to be an interesting call right here. Pat, Marcus Allen didn't make the first down. If I were Marty Schottenheimer, though, I would get a measurement to see exactly how much you need for the first down.
Well, you have the best. Well, and he's getting a measurement.
In fact, they are going to do that, because that always helps in your decision. Of course, if you don't have very far to go, and then you punt, it also gets the fans against you, too.
But when you have Marcus Allen, as you mentioned earlier,
see, now
the best in short yardage clutch situations like this, maybe you go for it.
And Marty and his emotion, I think part of it is his emotion, part of it is the fact that he likes that kind of football, and I think a little part of it is the influence that these fans have.
No question about it.
Maybe even a little more of the influence that the official has when he gives you this look here. You know, you only got that much to go.
About a foot. Back to Marcus Allen. And there's a reason he's the best on short yardage.
And it's just, you know, Marcus Allen was saying yesterday on short yardage, what he tries not to do is to see ghosts, you know, to think what's going to be there before you get there, to just let it happen, and it's all about a feel. Now, you would expect that they would be going inside, and they get them all packed inside, and they just come on a flip. They flip the ball to him on the outside, he gets a good lead, and then he knows exactly where that first down marker is and gets beyond it.
First down, Kansas City at the San Francisco 45. The fake is to Marcus Allen. And Gannon's pass is caught by Lake Dawson, and Dawson fights inside the 20 to about the 18. Lost his hat.
I tell you, that's the thing. After Marcus Allen gets in there and runs a few, and then you get that defense anchoring, then you can get a hold. You see, when you get that play pass and you come in here, that's going to hold this group, and then you can come in and find big holes in behind them. And that's exactly what happens. It all starts with a play pass. You see the play pass, and that affects everything. And now Dawson is able to come right across the middle, and there's no defense underneath. Why? Because they went for the play fake.
Right. First down. The fake handoff. Gannon rolls, and it's out of bounds. Intended for Risen, who dropped it, but he was out of bounds anyway.
One of the things that the 49er defense worries about is containing Rich Gannon, because, you know, we said how, you know, he has the speed, he has the quickness, and he is one of those guys that every time he goes back to pass is as dangerous running the ball as he is throwing it.
And the coaches all to a man yesterday said to us, he also makes very solid, very good decisions.
And Marty Schottenheimer, you know, in practice, I watch him in practice, tells him that every play.
Donnell Bennett inside the 10. Stopped by Junior Bryant.
They said they were going to go right at their strength, that they were going to take the ball and they were going to run it right at these two guys. The strength of that 49er defense, they were going to run it right at, and they're doing that.
They double them both.
Yep, they double them both. They get just a little crease. It doesn't take a heck of a big hole, just a little crease to boom, to get that ball through there. That's exactly what Bennett does. And then after he gets through there, he runs like a fullback.
Which, of course, he is.
Which, of course, he should run like. That's why they're paying him.
That's Marcus Allen. Not much.
Marcus Allen on there.
Yeah, that was that first down.
That was that short yardage play. They weren't trying to get much on that. You get third down inside the 10. You want to get the first down first and then go for the touchdown. I don't know that they got the first. Yeah,
they did. They did, yeah, get they did. The just first changed down. The marker. First and goal.
Watch Marcus Allen here, and you see why he's so good at this, because his feet never stop. You see, even right now, you see his feet, they're still going there, driving to get that first down.
First and goal at the 7. Chiefs already lead 7-3. Gannon back. Goes out of the pocket, and as John Madden's been saying, he can run. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 3.
And that really slows down a pass rush. Anytime a quarterback can run like that, then you say, we got to keep them contained. We have to stay in their lane. And all those are things that take away your aggressiveness. You see, Kevin Green takes an inside. And the minute that he takes an inside, Rich Gannon sees that, then he goes right outside.
They knocked him out of bounds at the 2. So it's second and goal at the 2. And would you look, if you were playing defense, for Marcus Allen to get the carry?
I think this play and the next play and the play after, but they're going to come and talk about it first.
It's a timeout. San Francisco called this timeout.
Nike Play Corps presents.
Coach, can I have a ride home?
Coach, can I blow your whistle?
Coach, when do I get to play?
Coach, why everyone bigger than me?
Can I go to the bathroom?
Coach, will you be mad if we lose?
Coach, when do I play quarterback?
Coach, where's my helmet?
Coach, when do I get to play?
Coach, when do Florida State play Green Bay?
Do you have a girlfriend?
Coach, can I go to the bathroom?
What are you guys doing? What are you doing? Hey, you know, the only time you guys yell box out is when you're out of donut. You guys remind me of my shoe closet. I got one penny and a bunch of loafers.
Thank you.
NFL Sunday is brought to you by the coaches of Nike Play Corps, by Cadillac DeVille for the time of your life, by Visa, the official card of the NFL that's everywhere you want to be, and by Aflac, insuring over 40 million people worldwide.
In Kansas City, we're at Arrowhead Stadium. Pat Summerall with John Madden. Second and goal at the 2, Kansas City. They've already gotten 73 yards rushing today. And that's more than the 49ers average. Gannon, touchdown. Gonzalez.
That was the play the offensive coordinator Paul Hackett called. You know, they took a timeout. They had a chance to talk about it. You see Marcus Allen again here. You give the playback. You make him hold in. Hold all this group here. Then you take your tight end and just sneak him right out there. Now watch the play fake. And you see here's Gonzalez right here. But watch what the play fake does. You see how it holds everyone there?
Yep.
Gonzalez sneaks out to the outside, and there's no defender near him.
Stojanovic makes it 14-3. Kansas City over San Francisco. The 49ers have won 11 straight. They've got their work cut out for them.
It was just one of those nights. It was just one of those fabulous rides.
When you're searching for something better, when you're looking for a change, every once in a while, you come across a Gossamer Bay. Capture something better.
Quick and nimble DeVille with the North Star system. DeVille, for the time of your life.
May I take your order, please?
Spicy chicken sandwich.
Wendy's spicy chicken is made with Dave's own blend of pepper and spices. It has a spicy hit that'll warm you up.
Yes?
Whatever the weather.
I'll have what he's having.
Great timepieces are built to run forever without replacing batteries. But only one of these is smart enough to run forever on any kind of light. Echo Drive from Citizen. Live at the speed of light.
Look who's joining high society.
I guess this makes us yuppies, huh?
I'm really more of a slacker.
The Simpsons, tonight at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
You know, we talk about play fake all the time, and it's the quarterback, and it's also the running back. You see the quarterback fake there? Now watch Marcus Allen. He just keeps running and running and running and, like, dives like he's going for the end zone. Of course, that holds all the linebackers, and it holds that strong safety, and then you can sneak someone, once you fake that, sneak someone free in the end zone.
Stojanovic kicks off to Chuck Levy at the goal line. Levy to the 30. Stopped by Joe Horn.
We saw the play fake part of it. Now watch Tony Gonzalez here, the rookie. He starts here, comes across in motion here, fakes a block here, and then just sneaks out into the end zone. See, so we saw the play fake part of it. Now watch Gonzalez come across. Now he's going to make a little block right here. See, boom, makes the guy play the block, and then sneaks off him free into the end zone.
He did that very well,
yeah.
Gonzalez.
In fact, they did all those things. Rich Gannon made a nice fake. Marcus Allen carried out the fake. Gonzalez made a good part of the fake by coming to a block and then getting out.
Brent Jones moves over to the right side of the San Francisco offense, and this is Garrison Hurst. Hurst out of bounds at about the 35 by Reggie Tung.
Did you see old Minuski going down there? Watch him. Here he is, number 51, one of the great special teams players in the league. And watch what happened. When you get down there, and you run that hard to get there, and you get there first, and then you miss the tackle, you have to go through those gyrations.
And knowing him, that's not an act.
No, it's not. Nothing that Minuski does is an act, believe me. Minuski's just a football player. He's a special teams guy.
On second down, Steve Young taken down. Fumble. The 49ers got it back. Garrison Hurst recovered Young's
they're
fumble.
They're throwing Steve Young around like a rag doll on these things. But this is a where they got him early. And here again on another, that was the penalty play. Here he scrambles and slides and still goes down, and then of course that last one. And that's one of the things that Steve Mariucci has gone to a more conservative offense. He said, really, the secret behind his offense is just to keep Steve Young healthy.
Young gives to Terry Kirby, who
Look
only
out.
Gets about
Hogan,
three.
You're going to get in a fight right there.
I don't know if Gogan's the guy I want to get in a fight with.
Yeah, but the thing is Gogan makes you get in fights with him. Because Gogan plays from the time the ball snapped until the whistle blows, yeah. And then a little beyond it.
I still don't know if I'm the easy guy I want to get in a fight with.
You don't want to get any JOPs around him, any of those jobs. You know, where you come after the play's over, yeah. You jump on the pile, because he'll pick you up. You do a job.
Kick is blocked. The punt's blocked. Thompson's punt is blocked by the Gonzalez, and the Chiefs have it inside the 49er five.
You know, everyone was saying what a great player Tony Gonzalez is going to be. Of course, he played for Steve Mariucci, the 49ers head coach, last year at the University of California. He caught a touchdown pass, and then lo and behold, he comes in and lays out. Now that is a great athletic move. Usually you block with two hands. Watch Tony Gonzalez come in here and just reach out with one hand, his right hand, and whap that thing down, and then go get it.
It didn't look like he was really trying to block it.
You know, they only sent one guy on that. Look, he's the only guy coming. He comes from the right side, and that looks like a basketball block.
Yep.
That's the way you block a shot in basketball. Tony Gonzalez blocked a punt.
First and goal at the three. Standing up.
The Kansas City Chiefs are taking it to the 49ers, and they're taking it to their defensive line. Yeah, yesterday all the Chiefs were saying, you know, we're not going to let these guys intimidate us. And no one in this locker room is in awe of the 49ers, and they really have come out in this first half and played that way.
I think they've intimidated the 49ers.
Look at this hole right here. I mean, there is no one that gets a hand on Marcus Allen. You see Ken Norton Jr., he was just standing up there, and they went right by him.
And that middle is the strength, or has been, of the 49er defense. Look at that.
And nimble DeVille with the North Star system.
Yeah, it's so good, cause now you're willing to make
DeVille, for the time of your life.
Beau pantalon.
Beau pantalon.
She says nice pants.
There's another boy.
Dockers, khakis. Isn't she lovely?
Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Let's spend 1 minute. Oh, I never thought through love with me, making one as lovely.
insuring over 40 million people worldwide.
First, she betrayed him. Now, is Kyle getting even?
I really don't think he wants to see you right now, you pathetic little parasite.
A brand new Melrose, Monday at 8, 7 Central.
Marcus Allen just added on to NFL history. Rushing touchdown number 121.
Let's watch a block that Dave Zott makes here. Here's Ken Norton. He's going to be standing right in the hole. Zott comes around, gets him, and hooks him right there. Norton should make this play. Because see him step up there? He's right in the hole. Now watch what Zott does to him right there. Hits him, holds him, turns him. No one touches Marcus Allen.
Levy. Back deep for the 49ers. Soyanovich to kick it off. Short kick. Bounces away from Levy, who touched it. Picked it up now. Chuck Levy. Take it down at about the 16. Things are falling apart quickly for the 49ers. Our Aflac trivia question. Which was the last team to win a Super Bowl without a 1,000-yard rusher? Got any ideas?
Yeah, I would think it's probably one of the two teams playing here today.
At Arrowhead?
At Arrowhead. When Kansas City, when the Chiefs won Super Bowl III, I think they had a 1,000-yard rusher in Mike Garrett.
I think they might have. Flag on the play.
Eric Thomas is saying that Derek Deese moved on that one, the left tackle, number 63.
Prior to the snap, false start, offense, number 63. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Derek Deese.
Yeah, Derek Deese was right here. And you see again, what he has to do is he has to block Derek Thomas on the outside. And Derek Thomas got wide on him. And when you have to block a speed rusher, that'll happen quite a bit.
Young. Pass complete to Owens. And right now for a McDonald's game break, let's return to James Brown at the Fox Television Center in Hollywood.
Pat, John, Carolina needs a victory to stay in the wild card hunt. Look at what the Saints are doing to him. Ray Zeller's 10-yard run. Saints on top 10-3 over Carolina. We'll get back to Kansas City. Pat and John.
It gets harder and harder to be able to predict what the heck is going to happen around the NFL. Young swings it out to Kirby.
You know, I think one of the reasons
for
that...
William Floyd, excuse me.
I was just going to say, Pat, one of the reasons for that is there's really no dominating teams in the league anymore. There are some good teams, and to me, that's the difference between being good and dominating. If you're a dominating team, you can have mistakes and still win. If you're a good team, if you have mistakes, you're going to lose.
And as you pointed out, although the Chiefs look like they're a pretty dominating team today,
they're dominating the 49ers in this first half.
Kirby in the backfield, three wide receivers. Here comes a Chief blitz, and down goes Steve Young. Not enough people left to protect.
Now, the 49ers are reverting to the team that started the season, not the team that's been in the middle and towards the end of this season. Watch the pressure. Here's Derek Thomas. Again, we talk about a speed rusher coming against Derek Deese. He just does it. He just runs right around him. Yep. I mean, Deese, at some point, you have to pop him. I mean, the guy comes and you have to give him a pop. You just can't take the ride, because if you take the ride on a speed rusher, he's going to ride you right into your quarterback.
He's going to leave you hitchhiking. Thompson's punt, and that's Vanover. Midfield, flag on the play. Another flag on the play as Vanover goes out of bounds at about the 45.
You know, and that's going to be one of those things where you get the gunner coming down, the two outside guys that can leave. The penalty happened on blocking them on the sideline. But the deal is, when the hat comes off, that means that a player went out of bounds. Now, if he goes out of bounds, he has to try to get back in. So if he doesn't try to get back in, it can be against the guy going down, against the gunner. If they knock him down and keep him out of bounds or lay him, then it can be against the guys that are blocking him. But there's something happening over in that sideline. Yeah. We don't know what it is, but you got a couple of heads without hats. So that's going to tell you that something happened happen way out of bounds. Say when you get those, and so that's going to be part of it. Then when you get the flag, then there's going to be a penalty involved in it. The hat just means that it happened, it's okay. The flag means that after it happened, then something else happened that they're going to throw a flag on it.
Now, after they throw the flag and the hat, what do they have left?
The beanbag.
Beanbag.
You see right there? Oops, we used to have a shot there. We don't have it anymore. But that thing in the front is a beanbag. The signal, it's against the 49ers. That right there is a beanbag. So they got the flag first, then the hat, then the beanbag.
What kind of beans, you know?
Well, no, I think they just have, you know, in the flag they have popcorn.
Right.
In the yellow flag. In fact, I carry one around with me all the
time. Unpopped.
Unsportsmanlike conduct on the kicking team, running out of bounds, not making an effort to come in, number 28. By rule, that penalty is declined. Personal foul. 82. Number 82 on the receiving team, late hit out of bounds, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Okay, now watch. Here's the first part, because he just gets out of bounds. They said that he stayed out of there too long. he's not trying to get back.
Curtis Buckley.
That was Curtis Buckley. So then, but that doesn't mean that you can take and have a personal foul too. So they didn't take that one. They take the personal foul.
Buckley was on the warning track. Derek Walker was the chief call for the personal foul.
And they aren't going to penalize the 49ers for it, he said. They are penalizing the Chiefs for it.
They're going to take some time to think about it right now. 21-3, Kansas City.
With formidable strength and a distinctly individual style, this Sierra is the most powerful half-ton truck in GMC's history. Sierra gives you the style to stand apart from the herd. And the power to pull it. Sierra by GMC, putting you comfortably in command.
ID confirmed.
Bond. James Bond.
ID confirmed. ID confirmed.
Take a check?
Absolutely, James. Just need some ID. Driver's license to kill, that's for the thing.
Really, 007, you should use a Visa check card. It automatically deducts from your checking account everywhere Visa's accepted. Oh, it's going to explode in 5 seconds.
The Visa check card works like a check, only better.
Just joking.
See, tomorrow never dies.
My name's Dan Mears of the Kansas City Chiefs. I take a lot of pride in wearing this uniform. I tell people I go to work every day in a suit and a tail.
5:08 left before the halftime. Kansas City 21, San Francisco 3. Look at the field position that Kansas City has had, as opposed to what San Francisco has faced. That's one of the reasons they lead. Greg Hill. Let's go back to that Aflac trivia question again. Which was the last team to win a Super Bowl without a 1,000-yard rusher? The last team. It was these 49ers in 1994 with Ricky Waters.
Yeah, that would be a good guess, because, you know, the 49ers were one of those teams that for a long time would use that short pass. That's kind of the West Coast offense, yeah, where you use that short pass in lieu of a run.
Hill wrapped up by McDonald, Tim McDonald.
I think the 49er defense is going to have to get Tim McDonald more involved in the run defense because they aren't having success with, you know, stopping them with that seven. And that's the thing we always talk about, that eight man up, that eighth man in the box. Well, of course, that eighth man becomes the strong safety, and when you're playing the 49ers, it becomes Tim McDonald. So I think on first and second down, especially, you know, the running type down, I think we'll see more and more of Tim McDonald up around the line of scrimmage.
Third down, three wide receivers set up for Kansas City. Gannon straight back this time. And now straight forward. Rich Gannon will get a first down before he is knocked backwards. But he still gets all the way to the 45, and they'll move the sticks.
Yeah, Bryant Young got penetration, and the thing the 49ers talked about, the number one thing that they had to do is to be able to contain Rich Gannon. Now watch right here. Bryant Young does get by Will Shields. You see him break free right here? He's going to break free right there. And that's the thing that makes Rich Gannon start to run. He starts a little to his right, and then no one has their lanes in the middle. No, there's no containment on the outside. And like I said, when you start worrying about lanes and containment and all those things, that takes away aggressiveness and pass rush.
Two tight ends set up. Whistle on the play quickly.